heard the old man's getting out.
I didn't think they just let pedophiles out like that.
He's been in there for a year. We've got all his money. He might not have anywhere else to go.
Go ahead.
What happened here?
Vagrants, probably.
It sounds like you need to own up to some of the things you've done.
So either give me my money or kill me.
Sorry, sir. You're not supposed to be here.
I'm Agent Hudson with the SIB.
The victim's a 70-year-old male, no next of kin. There was a vehicle seen leaving a few nights ago.
Oh, it's dead.
How did it happen?
He was shot in the head. Arthur, this is a good thing. We're in the clear. He was the only thing in the way.
I just left a crime scene where one of your officers was literally lying in a pool of blood. I'm not sure how you do things around here, but I'm starting to get the idea. The likelihood of finding any usable evidence is faint at best. Did you kill Lloyd Mickey?
No. Can't say I'm going to be of much help to you, neither.
I could work with that.
Drop it!
Tell me what you know, and I don't want you to skip any details. Trying to solve a murder. Now I'm gonna follow this thing wherever it goes to whoever it goes. I don't care what I turn up, as long as it's the truth. There was a real murder here. It looks like I'm the only one trying to get to the bottom.
Is everything okay with your case?
I'm getting close.
Wasn't there something I could help you with?
Run.
Pardon me?
Run.
Hey, it's Valeria here. For all you martial arts fans, I have some interesting facts on Jackie Chan. Being one of the greatest action heroes of all time, it's not surprising to know that he really does all of his own stunts, and they have cost him. While Chan was shooting the accidental spy, his tailbone was hit so hard that it caused temporary partial paralysis. His worst accident by far, which was a near-death experience, was caused by a pretty mundane stunt, jumping onto a tree. He missed the tree and hit the rocky ground head first. That resulted in a piece of his skull being cracked and going into his brain, and he had blood pouring from his ears. Chen had to have an 8-hour emergency brain surgery, which obviously was successful, and now has a permanent hole in his head secured with a plastic plug. Martial arts fans, you know him as Tony Jaa, but did you know his real name is Japanum Yerum and that his parents are elephant herders? Jaa became fascinated by the world of martial arts after watching movies as a young kid. His main influences have come from Jackie Chan, Jet Li and Bruce Lee, stating they are his masters and that what they did was so beautiful, so heroic, that he wanted to do it too. He practiced until he could do the moves exactly as he had seen the masters do it. Bruce Lee was a heavy fighter who threw hard punches. Jackie moves very fast and uses a lot of comedy. And Jet Li is very fluid. He has tried to combine all of their styles and added some things of his own to create his own unique style.
And I've got some interesting facts on Bruce Lee. Did you know that when editing movies starring Lee, the editors had to slow his action scenes down so people could see what he was doing? Now, Lee also had bad eyesight, and it's one of the reasons he appreciated Wing Chun's contact style of movement, because he could rely more on touch than sight. The actor also voiced most of the English voices in his films. Yep, all the English-speaking guys in Way of the Dragon, apart from the mighty Chuck Norris, and his other Hong Kong films released before Enter the Dragon, were voiced by the main man himself.
I have a bonus fact for you about none other than Jean-Claude Van Damme. Now, sources have that Van Damme turned down the role of Johnny Cage in Mortal Kombat to star in Street Fighter. The irony is the Mortal Kombat game was initially developed as a Jean-Claude Van Damme video game, and Johnny Cage was modeled after his portrayal of Frank Dux in Bloodsport. had he taken the role. Jean-Claude Van Damme would have been playing a portrayal of himself, portraying another martial artist. Wow, how confusing. Fighting is without a doubt the oldest form of competition that mankind has ever engaged in, and nowhere is appreciation for the beauty of fighting more apparent than in martial arts cinema. So let's celebrate the genre with the following top 10. Coming in at number 10 is Iron Monkey from 1993, the quintessential Hong Kong martial arts film of the 90s, starring Donnie Yen and Yu Rongguang. Number 9 is Tony Jaa's Tom Yam Goong, also known as The Protector, from 2005. At number 8 is Five Element Ninjas, or Chinese Super Ninjas, from 1982, directed by Chan Che. This movie is as crazy as Kung Fu gets, but you've got to love it for its entertaining excesses. Jackie Chan's best movie by far comes in at number 7, Drunken Master 2, also known as The Legend of Drunken Master, from 1994. Number 6 is Ang Lee's Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon, and number 5 is Crippled Avengers from 1978, directed by Chan Che. Number 4 is Sui Hark's masterpiece Once Upon a Time in China, starring Jet Li. Bruce Lee's most essential film, Enter the Dragon, is at number 3, and number 2 is The 36th Chamber of Shaolin, starring Gordon Liu. And what you have all been waiting for, coming in at number 1 on our list, is 1978's Five Deadly Venoms from director Chen Chen. It's everything that's wonderful about martial arts movies, beautiful choreography and timeless stories of good versus evil. So what do you think? Do you agree with our list? Let me know in the comments below, and remember to subscribe to our channel for all the best martial arts action movie releases.